Egypt continues to burn over again, rising protests and fury over their President Mubarak. And again, 1 million strong protests is what is expected tomorrow on Tuesday. And in the middle of this crisis in Egypt is the millionaire from Chennai, Arun Joseph, who works as an HR manager with a call center major and again is stuck in Alexandria waiting for a chartered flight to bring him back home. Now, NDTV Hindu got in touch with Arun just a while back while he was waiting at the airport, Alexandria Airport in Egypt, awaiting his flight back home. This is, of course, an NDTV Hindu exclusive.
So for the first last couple of days, they've burned down all the police stations. So there's been jailbreaking. We have a lot of thieves who jailbroke, and there are no cops in the city protecting people. We only have the military. I think the military is trying to help the people to safeguard, but I think there's too much of looting that's happening in terms of commercial stuff, residential stuff. So right now, people themselves are taking weapons in their hands to protect their own houses, household. I think today, they're trying to do a bigger protest compared to the last couple of days. I think I'm assuming things will be really bad. It's a fear that it's not your own country, and you don't know the language too well. And I think you feel much safer once you're outside. So,
right.
And as far as people that are with me are concerned, we're just leaving so that things calm down, and I'm sure all of us will be back again. Our company has taken care of us really well, and so they've kind of arranged the charter flight to get us out of here. But we don't know exactly. We're kind of waiting for the flights to land. It looks like it's going to be a delay of a couple of hours.
And while Arun is in Alexandria, he was stuck in a car for hours on Sunday. Stuck inside a car, he and his colleagues watched in horror as other cars around them were burnt. Now, NDTV Hindu has its hands on this conversation between Arun and his Chennai-based cousin Deepak, who shared this conversation with us. Take a look.
A nation engulfed by a wave of protests. And in the middle of the chaos that is Egypt, is this Tamilian, Arun Joseph.
Sorry, now.
An employee of a popular call center company, Arun Joseph was stuck in a building for over 48 hours on Saturday. Around 40 of his colleagues were with him, and so was a 4-year-old child, the daughter of a colleague. As an Egyptian contact helped them get out of the building and find a hotel, Arun got into a car with his colleagues, and for a part of the time he was in the car, he was in conversation with his Chennai-based cousin, Deepak. The streets of Egypt filled with protesters, civilians holding knives and sticks to guard their own. As Arun's car goes through these streets to reach a hotel, they're stopped for scrutiny every few meters. And even while they navigate the streets of Alexandria, these men try to make sense of the situation. They sympathize and they even try to justify what's happening to them.
Everybody was having a knife in his pocket and one stick in his hand.
But just when Arun believes he might be only 5 minutes away from the hotel he's supposed to reach, he hits yet another roadblock. This time, the men stopping the car belong to the army.
Wait. Army is stopping. still AK-47s with knives. Opposite direction.
Why are they not looking that side?
Army, yeah?
And they turn around. Arun's family now hopes that their ordeal ends soon, that he returns home safe along with the thousands of other Indians stuck in the troubled nation. Bureau Report, NDTV Hindu.
Well, near to home in some action from our districts. In the Vilupuram district, Devapattinam village near Kalakuruchi, parents of about 1,000 girl students protested against the headmaster of the school, alleging misbehavior. And the parents staged the demonstration in the school premises, demanding action against the headmaster. Now, education department officials rushed to the spot and assured that action would be taken. Now, the protest comes after repeated complaints of the students. Krishnan, the 42-year-old headmaster, was allegedly misbehaving with the girls and subjecting them to physical abuse. Now, the protesting parents threatened that they would hold another protest if action is not taken immediately. Meanwhile, the Prime Minister Manmohan Singh has assured that the steps would be taken to prevent attacks on Tamil Nadu fishermen by Sri Lankan Navy in a letter written to the MDMK General Secretary Vaiko. As a follow-up to Vaiko's meeting with the Prime Minister on January 22nd, the letter from the Prime Minister also mentioned visit of Foreign Secretary Nilappama Rao to Colombo to discuss the issue of security of Tamil fishermen with Sri Lankan government. Well, the Madras High Court today gave directions to Tamil Nadu Textbook Corporation to rectify the reported mistakes in the Telugu medium social science textbook of 6th standard. Now, Sanjeeva Rao, a Telugu expert, filed a petition in the High Court mentioning numerous errors in it. Now, the errors include the spelling mistake in Tamil sage poet Thiruvalluvar's name. The name was spelled as Thiruvalluvar in the textbook. Now, the book reportedly has errors on almost every alternate page. The first bench ordered that the Textbook Corporation look into this and rectify the mistakes as soon as possible.
Tamil Nadu அரசு ஆறாவது வகுப்புக்கு தெலுங்கு சோஷியல் சயின்ஸ் புக்கில் ஏகப்பட்ட மிஸ்டேக்ஸ் போட்டு அதை திருத்தாமலே அது ஈவன் மறுபரிசீலனை கூட செய்யாமலே பள்ளிக்கூடத்துக்கு அனுப்பிக்க ஆரம்பித்தார்கள். அந்த புத்தகத்தை அடிப்படையாக வச்சு கூட பரீட்சைகள் நடந்திருக்கின்றன. அதில் தவறுகள் இருக்குதுன்னு சொல்லிட்டு நானே ஒரு லாயர் நோட்டீஸ் என்னுடைய கிளையண்ட் சார்பிலாக கொடுத்தேன். அதற்கு எந்த விதமான பதிலும் இல்லை. பதில் இல்லாத காரணத்தினால இந்த நீதிமன்றத்தில் ஒரு பில் போட்டு டைரக்ஷன் வாங்கியிருக்கிறேன். நீதிமன்றம் என்ன சொல்லியிருக்குன்னா அந்த புஸ்தகத்தில் உள்ள என்னென்ன மிஸ்டேக் இருக்குங்கிறத ஒரு லிஸ்ட் எடுத்து அந்த டைரக்டர் ஆஃப் ஸ்கூல் எஜுகேஷனுக்கு தெரிவித்து அதெல்லாம் ரெக்டிஃபை பண்ண சொல்லி சொல்லணும். அந்த மிஸ்டேக்ஸ் எல்லாம் மிஸ்டேக்காக இருந்தால் அந்த புஸ்தகத்தை திருப்பி வாங்கணும். அதை பப்ளிஷ் அதை சர்க்குலேட் பண்ணி பள்ளிக்கூடத்தில் மாணவர்களுக்கு படிக்க கொடுக்கக்கூடாது.
Well, the wait for eager fans of Rajnikanth is over and it is indeed going to be a treat for their eyes. Watch out for the superstar in triple action. Keep watching on the other side.